I'm Ilyan St. Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to take a look at Mesh Central support for AceBase database. Obviously, if you're going to run Mesh Central, you need a database. You need somewhere to store the user accounts, the devices, device group, user groups, all the events, the power state changes, and everything else. And so the database is super critical to how Mesh Central works. So let's take a look at the databases that Mesh Central supports. And I'm going to use a few slides here to show that Mesh Central has now, as of this recording, 6 databases that it supports in the back end. And so the reason why Mesh Central supports 6 is that when Mesh Central is installed by any user, usually it has to fit well within an existing infrastructure. So if you have Nginx as a reverse proxy, if you have Docker as your container or Kubernetes, or you're using Windows or so on, and then maybe you have various databases, you're using MySQL or MongoDB or so on. So what Mesh Central is attempting to do is to fit very nicely within a wide range of different existing environment so that it can co-locate with other services nicely. And so you don't have to install a new database for Mesh Central. You can use your existing one. So out of these 6, there's 2 that are a little different. So PostgreSQL, Mongo, Maria, and MySQL, those are database, like professional databases that you would install on your back end. Sometimes you install them in a cluster on a different computer. And that's great. They're like enterprise-grade databases. And then there's these 2 other ones, NeDB and the recently added AceBase database. And those are interesting because they are local databases. They're pure Node.js databases. So for users who install Mesh Central and don't want to install a separate database, they just want to have it run as a local self-contained service, then Mesh Central needs to use a local database so it can store stuff to file and retrieve it and, you know, do indexing, searching through the databases very, very quickly. And so AceBase and NeDB are 2 local databases that you don't need anything else. You just say, I'm using NeDB or I'm using AceBase. Mesh Central will load the right code from NPM. And you can go right away. And at the time of this recording, the default is currently NeDB. So when you install Mesh Central for the first time and you just run it without configuring anything at all, then NeDB is the database that's going to be used to create the initial records and so on and so forth. And then usually that's great for learning. It's great for small instances with, you know, less than 1,000 nodes. And, you know, if you have 10, 50 users, that's fine. But if you're going to grow to a much larger instance, I very, very much suggest you switch to one of the enterprise ones. Now, the problem with NeDB is that it's been out of support for a long time. Now, I'm going to look at the database on GitHub for NeDB, and you'll see that there's not been a single update in 7 years. And then 13 months ago, they finally put a message saying that the database is no longer maintained. And so you're free to fork it, but you know there's plenty of security issues and so on and so forth. They're not going to continue using NeDB. In fact, if I were to use this version right here, there would be a whole bunch of issues with the database, the security issues. And so there are forks of NeDB that solve those security issues, and that's what Mesh Central uses. So I don't use the main one from the author, the main author. I use one that's been forked and that has the security issues fixed, so that when you do an NPM audit, you know, NeDB doesn't report any error on the one that Mesh Central has. But this is still a problem because the default database Mesh Central uses is basically an unsupported database. So somebody on GitHub pointed me to AceBase, and I'll go and bring up that webpage. Let's see right here. And so of course that one, you know, there's active development on it. The, you know, 19 days ago was the last update. There's lots of patches. There's a bunch of releases. And so, and I really like all the documentation on it. It's just, you know, it explains really well how to use this database and so on and so forth. So, but of course the key thing here is that AceBase, just like NeDB, is a pure Node.js database. And so you can, there's not going to be a problem with running on Windows, on Linux, on BSD, on Mac, and on any processor, whether it's Intel or ARM or Apple Silicon or so on. Because it's a pure Node.js database, it will run on everything. So that is wonderful. So at some point, the idea will be to transition the default from NeDB to AceBase, and eventually maybe in long term to get rid of NeDB completely and, you know, transition to AceBase. So that's kind of the plan. But right now, AceBase has been added, and the idea is to not make it the default right away, but make it so that at least I can start using it on my developer server, you know, use it daily, see how it works, iron out the kinks. If there's any performance issues, I can go and fix those and see how it goes. So by default, NeDB is used and you don't need any settings. But if you want to use AceBase, you go in the settings section of your config.json and you just say AceBase equal true, and that will do it. There's also very interesting things with AceBase that could be looked at in the future. AceBase can be used as a front end for other databases, so it's not impossible in the future I could support more databases through AceBase. But for now, I'm going to use the basically their built-in database engine that is in Node.js. Okay, and then one other thing before I go into the demo, AceBase has a sponsoring has a banner, and if you put sponsor equal true in the config.json, then that banner will disappear. So let's go and demo this. So I'm gonna have my trusty developer server right here. I'm gonna bring back up the web page. So I have my server running. I can, of course, click and run and so on, but I am using NeDB right now. So I can click on the My Server console, type info, and you will see database, it says NeDB. So that's what I'm using. So I wanna transition to AceBase. Now, the way I'm gonna do it is open my config.json, it's right here, and I am going to add the line in the settings section, AceBase true, like that, and then I'm going to reset the server. Now, first thing you're gonna see is this banner over here, and as I talked about, you can put the sponsor true and then remove this banner. If you're running Mesh Central in the background, it doesn't really matter if there's a banner or not. Although I do encourage people sponsoring projects, so that seems like a good one. Okay, so I have that running now. Now, normally, when you transition from NeDB to any other database, you will, you know, it's obviously a new database. It will start completely empty, so you won't be able to log in. You won't have your devices and so on and so forth. So normally, and I covered this in another video, but normally what you would do is comment out AceBase, you would run meshcentral --db export, and you say bob.json, for example, enter, and this will export all, you know, the most important records will be exported into this JSON file. Then what you do is you put acebase, you remove the underscore here, and then you run db import. And I won't do it right now, but if I were to hit enter here, it would take a little bit and then say that these records were re-imported into the new database. So that's how you transition from one database to another. Now, I cover this in other videos, but I'm just going to go ahead and run Mesh Central now with the acebase database. I've already imported my my records, so if I can log in here as my account, and you see the machine show up, and I can click and say connect and so on and so forth, and it works. So basically, surprisingly enough, you should see no difference. You know, if this all works perfectly well, you should see absolutely no difference between NeDB and acebase. But just to take a look at this in more detail, there is a little bit of the difference. If you go in meshcentral-data, now I have a lot of files here, but I want you to focus on those four files. The .db files, these are the NeDB files. So obviously, if you delete this and you're using NeDB, you'll lose your data. For acebase, it creates a folder called meshcentral.acebase. And so when you click on this, right now there's a data.db file in here, but there can be some temporary files and index files and stuff that can happen and can be here. So don't worry too much what's inside this folder, but just note that NeDB uses, you know, the .db files, and then acebase will use this meshcentral.acebase folder, and then inside of it everything will be you know, all the data that would normally be in these files would be in the acebase folder. I will also note that data.db here will contain all of the major records, plus the events, the power state records, the service stats. All of that will be inside this folder. So when you're backing up the database or doing or restoring the database, just be aware, you know, that this is acebase and this is NeDB. Okay, so hopefully that's good. Oh, one last thing I want to show you is the sponsor thing. So if you do sponsor acebase, you can go ahead and put acebase sponsor true here, and then when you run it, it won't show the banner. There you go. So that's the last demo of it. Hopefully this will make Mesh Central. I don't know if it's going to be faster than NeDB. I suspect it's going to be about the same, but certainly it will make Mesh Central much more less reliant on obsolete code or code that's not maintained. So that's always a really, really good thing. So thank you very much, and have a great day.